Canelo was never really a seek and destroy guy. Like, everyone was criticizing him against Floyd because he didn't hunt him down. That's not really Canelo. No, Canelo's much more comfortable, though he can punch.
Countering
when someone comes to him, which is why this matchup was so great on paper going into the first fight and turned out to be so great. One guy wants you to stay right there, Triple G, so we can go get you. The other guy wants to stay right there so you can come to him and you get that kind of combustion. But Dan, it seems to me that a lot of people are taking Canelo because the sense is, what can Triple G do? That again, only harder. Whereas Canelo has more that he can go to because he's more versatile, because he's the counterpuncher, he's the boxer. How do you feel about that?
I think that it's possible, but I also think there are things that Triple G didn't do in the first fight that he can do better
like in
the second fight, like go to the body that was wide open for him, that he did not employ that body attack. Now, Canelo has a good body attack also, but Canelo used it a little bit more, I think, than Golovkin did.
He also counters with that uppercut.
He does. Look, this is why it's a great matchup, because we can have this kind of dispute, this kind of debate, this kind of discussion about why we think either guy can win. It's that even up of a fight. But I also know what I saw the first fight, and I saw a Canelo Alvarez that stuck to a certain kind of game plan that, in my opinion, was not effective enough. I'm not sure that he's able to make that kind of enough change where it's going to be better. I think Golovkin could fight that same kind of way and still come out with the win that he deserved. And also, I'll say this, Stephen A., if it's close, those judges know what happened the first time. It might be in the back of their mind. Mm-hmm. They may give Triple G the benefit of the doubt so as not to have that kind of outrageous controversy.
Let me come to both you and Max with this question. We've seen many fights. We've seen the promotional angles associated with many fights. How real is it when they talk about the absence of respect that presently exists compared to what existed in the first fight, when you consider the bad meat, clenbuterol, I believe was the drug Canelo got busted with. Triple G basically accused him of cheating. Oscar De La Hoya and
called
Golden Boy Promotions.
And a doper, yeah.
Oscar De La Hoya and Golden Boy Promotions said, hey, the second fight was supposed to be in May. They're the ones who insisted to complain about Canelo, and now Canelo is feeling the way he's. How real is this animosity in y'all mind?
It's real. I did no doubt about it. And what sticks out in my mind is, you know, the Sunday prior to the first fight, I went to Dodger Stadium when Triple G threw out the first pitch. We were going to caravan to Vegas for the fight. And I interviewed him, and he talked about someday, you know, he was going to go into the fight, but he had a tremendous amount of respect for Canelo Alvarez. He said, I think someday our children could play together, and we'll have dinner together. Then what happened, and it's completely that's just blown out of the park. They won't even face off with each other at the press conference.
Right. They didn't do a face off with me this time.
There you go.
Would have been good.
Yeah.
We're going to talk about this with Teddy Atlas, too, because he gets very into the psychology of the fight.
Yeah.
The first fight was missing two things. It was a great fight. But it was missing two things.
A good decision. Three things.
I gave it to Triple G 8-4.
Right.
But two of the first three rounds I gave.
I didn't realize you did 8-4.
Two of the first three rounds I gave to Canelo, two of the last three. But I could see an argument for giving the first three and the last three to Canelo. You get a draw. So I can accept 6-6. And the reason I could is because for all the Mexican-style talk that Triple G had going into the fight, he did fight that way. He put pressure, he fought behind a jab, but when he got Canelo on the ropes, there was all this pressure for him finally on the big stage to come through, and he didn't, to me it seemed, want to risk against those counters to the level that a guy like Julio Cesar Chavez Sr., who was the Mexican-style fighter, would risk in a big fight. He would get all the way in when he got his man on the ropes and stay there. So the question then becomes, is there enough motivation for Triple G to do it here? And here's the other thing the first fight missed. It wasn't a grudge match. It was a great fight. It was a great build-up, great fight. But they didn't hate each other.
Now they did.
This is a grudge match on top of it.
But so y'all think they really, really dislike each other?
Yeah, they're mad. Yeah, yeah. They're mad at each other. Yep.
I'm going to tell you what.
He called him a cheater and a doper.
If they won't do a face-off,
that's real. I understand Canelo feeling that way. Where's the animosity coming from in regards to Triple G?
Triple G feels like he was cheated.
Okay.
And Canelo is tired of having him complain and say that he cheated when he claims that he was innocent. And he's tired of Triple G, who was never a big talker, has been chirping about the PEDs from the moment this rematch was made.
You know what else? You know what happens? Boxing requires a lot of cooperation. You know what happens when a fight gets canceled? You don't get paid.
Yeah.
So Triple G's looking like at Canelo like, hold on, you cost me millions last year because you cheated. Canelo's looking at Triple G like, your side is the one that stopped the fight from going on. We could have made out a deal. I lost millions of dollars because you guys didn't want to play ball.
Here's what happened. In May, Triple G fought the replacement fight.
That's right.
Against Vonis Martirosyan. He made about $1 million, maybe a little more. That's a far cry from the 20, whatever he'll make, right, had that rematch.
And Canelo
happened,
made $0, yes, not fighting.
So there's a grudge. I can tell you this. If they didn't have that kind of grudge, a real one, they would have stood in front of each other and posed for the pictures yesterday after the press conference, because that helps sell
see
the
this stuff. Got to see how Triple G gets back out, gets out of range. He's Mexican style. When you have your guy on the ropes, is you get all the way in, put your head on his chest, really work the body. That was Julio Cesar Chavez. That's the guy that Abel Sanchez got is to model Triple G after. But that takes the willingness to be knocked out.
Triple
himself.
G is also taller. Julio Cesar Chavez was shorter, and it was easier for him as a target to get to the body more so
Canelo
than a Triple G, at least in this last fight.
A lot smaller going into
last,
this fight also, no question about
that's
it.
That's what Oscar was bragging about. The Oscar De La Hoya was bragging about that.
I'm not sure it's anything
smaller
to brag about.
Chavez was willing to walk through the right hand of Edwin Rosario, and once he got there, to stay in there. And Triple G, to me, seemed more tentative to take those counters from Canelo, and I think that's because he hadn't been on that stage yet. In fact, in our first face-off for the rematch, he talked about this.
But Max,
he hadn't been on that stage yet, and he didn't want to take that risk.
Who hurt who in the first fight? Triple G hurt
Canelo. Triple G, I felt, won the fight.
No, but who? I'm not talking who won. Who hurt the other guy? Canelo did not hurt Triple G, in my opinion.
No, but he hit him with some heavy shots.
He hit him with some heavy shots.
Head
later, I think it was the 10th or 11th round, he caught him off balance. When did he hurt Canelo?
Round 7, the round that Adelaide Bird, who had such a horrible score, she gave him that round.
Okay.
Listen, that's the controversy. He's not Bird's score.
There were some times in the first fight where you saw Canelo go upside his head, and you were like, oh, Triple G may have felt that one.
Do you ever hear him so excited like this? Before we let you go, Dan, and I'll ask both of you this, for the casual fan, what's one thing we should be watching for in this fight?
Great action.
All right, Matt?
Non-stop action.